Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 13 has been one of the most buggiest releases of iOS in recent history. In fact, it's probably buggier than iOS 11, which everyone considered to be incredibly full of bugs. Then iOS 12 fixed it, and then iOS 13 brought all those bugs back. Now, according to a Bloomberg story that was released today, it appears that Apple is very aware of all the bugs, and of course they're going to be. Not only are we submitting feedback here, and I've had other videos showing you how to submit feedback in different ways, but on top of that, Apple actually has scales of rating things as far as bugs and severity and all those sorts of things. And so in a new memo, they've actually said that the reason for this and all of the bugs is the way they were actually developing iOS 13. And they're going to change that, especially with iOS 14. So what I mean by that is currently the way things are built, or at least up to this time the memo was released, so maybe they've changed it since. But basically, you've got daily builds where people would actually be creating code to put in, say, a new feature. Maybe they changed or update the AirPods look for the headphones and things like that. Just little things. And then on top of that, you have a bunch of other features they're trying to add. So the first thing you need to understand is that different features are built by different teams. So maybe you have one team that's working on the core operating system. Then you have another team that works on the Notes app, or maybe they work on multiple apps. And then you have another team that works on music, and then another one that works on messages. So all of these different teams are working on different things at the exact same time so that they can get things done efficiently and then also focus on the quality of that code. Well, at the same time, all of these different teams that are responsible for these different features are working together and then putting everything in a build of the version of iOS or all the software at once. So for example, maybe you're building a house and while someone's already working on the foundation, people are building on top of that and you never had a chance to actually check that foundation to make sure that it was solid before you built on top of that. And at the same time, someone's adding a window and then maybe a sink and all of those things at the same time without testing to make sure that the things are solid that you're building onto really creates this problem that we're seeing now. And so Apple is aware of this, and instead they're working to change the way they test things. So previous to this, they would just clump all of that together. So now Apple is actually implementing a new testing procedure internally. So we won't see these effects directly, but we'll see the results of quality in the end. So what that means is maybe someone is working on music, for example. They're going to implement a bunch of new features, or maybe they're going to redesign it altogether for iOS 14. Well, they want to try their code out, but they don't want it to have to affect everyone. So they can actually implement their code for the internal versions of iOS. Then they can turn the feature on and off to test it out, but not leave it on so that it affects everything else. But at the same time, they'll be able to turn it on and test to see how it impacts the rest of the operating system as a whole. So this procedure should add to higher quality and more reliability. So they're kind of doing this where it seems like they should have been doing this all along, but I'll be honest, I'm not a software developer, so that may be the way things are done. I'm not really sure. But basically what they're doing is they're trying to isolate the impact of each individual change to the OS and then testing it individual. See, Apple actually measures software on a scale of 0 to 100. And apparently, and again, this is according to the Bloomberg memo that they got from Apple or that someone leaked to them from Apple, is iOS 12 had far less bugs and had a higher scale of quality on that rating system. Apparently with iOS 13, that rating system has come down quite a bit. And then they also have severity of bugs and things like that. And I've talked about this a little bit before, is when you submit feedback, they assign a severity or a priority to it of 0 through 5, with 0 being the most critical and 5 being a minor issue. And then they also assign a color as far as development goes with what they indicate as far as quality. So you've got kind of a stoplight, a red, yellow, and green. And so with all of these things combined, they're going to make the software even better. So that means with iOS 14, they're going to really focus on quality as opposed to all of these new features and things like that. And supposedly iOS 14 is going to be very feature-packed still, but not without being thoroughly tested prior to its release. So iOS 12, when it came out in beta form, was probably the most stable beta in many, many years since iOS 7. So I would say if they do the same thing there, we'll see the same results with iOS 14. Now, what this means with iOS 13 is that we're going to see stability with iOS 13. So when I started using the iPhone XS Max on iOS 13, it was some of the most unstable software I've used in a very long time. I had all sorts of issues with connectivity to LTE, everything from crashes to bugs, Bluetooth not working, Wi-Fi wasn't working sometimes. We had all sorts of issues. And then even with the release of the iPhone 11 Pro, Pro Max, and 11, there were still a ton of issues. We felt like, and we know now, that it was sort of rushed out with all of these bugs to get this working. So it looks like Apple's really changing that. And then even pushing further to iOS 15, it's going to be all about stability. So 14 and 15 are going to be very, very stable if everything holds true and everything works well. And so this was great news to hear today, and I thought I'd just share it with you and explain how things are changing. So now they'll be able to actually build a foundation of the house, make sure it's good, then build on that, make sure that's good, put in windows, then put in flooring and sinks and things like that and new features while assuring that the foundations are good to build upon. So hopefully that's great news for us. And we probably won't see as many public releases then, and it'll be more like iOS 11. With iOS 13, we have so many public releases in the first 2 months, it's a little ridiculous. With iOS 12, we had two. Now we've had 5 or 6. So it's a little bit much at this point. Now, finally, I wanted to share one piece of news with you that ABC apparently said in an interview with Tim Cook, the head of Apple, that for the company's future, he doesn't have his eye on anything big, but on a bunch of interesting small things. And so I'm not so sure that that was in context or not, because iPhone releases are seen as pretty big things. The new Mac Pro is seen as a pretty big thing, and we should see that in December. And I'm not sure what that really means in general. Maybe there's not anything revolutionary, maybe game-changing yet, or maybe there is. But Apple's pretty tight-lipped about that, and they don't really share a lot about future products. Also, on December 2nd, there is an Apple event for app developers. So that'll be pretty interesting to see what they're doing specifically. I'm not sure. And we don't really expect any new products. Maybe we'll see some new software for iOS. I know I would welcome Final Cut Pro for iPad, but I really don't keep my hopes up for that. But we may see some interesting things there. So on December 2nd, they should have that event. Hopefully they live stream it so we can take a look, but we don't really know the details of that yet. But let me know your thoughts about this in the comments below. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.